Today we are going to discuss the quantum cryptography. As the name suggests, quantum cryptography is based on the principles of quantum mechanics. In this video, we are going to discuss what is quantum cryptography, why it is needed, what are its different protocols and limitations. As discussed, quantum cryptography is based on the principles used in quantum physics. It uses different principles of quantum mechanics like superposition, entanglement, and uncertainty principle. Now, question arises, why do we need quantum cryptography? When quantum computers arrive, all the conventional schemes which are currently being used to secure the information will be vulnerable. The reason is that these schemes are based on different mathematical problems which can be easily solved by the quantum computers. For example, most of the cryptographic schemes are used on the basis of factorization problem. This problem can be easily solved by the Shor's algorithm in quantum computers. Hence, all the information which has been encrypted by the algorithms based on the factorization problem will be decrypted easily by the quantum computers. Hence, there is a need for a new type of cryptographic schemes which cannot be broken by the quantum computers. These type of schemes are called post-quantum cryptography. Post-quantum cryptography has many categories, and quantum cryptography is just one category of the post-quantum cryptography. The difference between quantum cryptographic protocols and the other protocols of post-quantum cryptography is that the other protocols are mainly based on the mathematical problems which cannot be solved by the quantum computers. Besides using the principles of quantum mechanics, quantum cryptography also uses the classical information theory principles. It ensures that all the transmission errors are corrected and the key is not disclosed to the eavesdropper. To achieve these two goals, quantum cryptography uses the techniques from classical information theory, which is called secret key distillation. By using the concepts of quantum mechanics, quantum cryptography not only offers the ability to detect that whether the information has been detected by an eavesdropper or not, it also offers the benefit of OTP or one-time pair. Using quantum cryptography, we can distribute long keys as often as sender and receiver require. This ensures the complete security of the information exchanged between two parties. The main application of quantum cryptography is the quantum key distribution, which is the exchange of key between two parties. For this purpose, two things are required, which is quantum general and quantum carrier. Quantum carrier are the particles that carry the information between parties, while quantum general is a medium through which quantum carriers travel. Quantum carrier can be anything which obeys the laws of quantum mechanics, but practically, photons are used for this purpose. While for quantum channel, we can use fiber optics for telecommunication networks or even open air for the satellite communication. Please note that quantum cryptography does not need quantum computers. It uses conventional techniques to distribute the key between two parties, and this key is then later on used in the conventional cryptographic schemes to exchange the information. Generally speaking, the process of the key distribution over quantum cryptography is that sender encodes some random information over photons. This information does not have to be meaningful, it can be anything. This information is transmitted to the receiver over a quantum channel. The receiver compares a fraction of the information received to detect whether the information has been intercepted or not. If there is any transmission error, it can be corrected using the secret key distribution techniques. Now let's suppose there is an evil actor which is intercepting the communication between sender and receiver. What happens is that according to the laws of quantum mechanics, when a photon is observed, its state is changed. Therefore, when an evil actor intercepts the transmission, it alternates the state of the photons that has been sent from the sender. When transmission reaches the receiver, he can easily detect whether the information has been intercepted from an evil actor or not. Another benefit of using quantum cryptography is that quantum key distribution process can be carried out over a public channel. Now, question arises, why a public channel? The answer is that if sender and receiver had access to a private channel, they would not need to use the quantum cryptography in the first place, and the information can be exchanged over the private channel using the conventional cryptographic schemes. Quantum key distribution protocols can be generally categorized into three different categories: the continuous variable, discrete variable, and distributed phase reference. The discrete variable protocol uses the discrete properties of photons, like its phase, to encode information, while the continuous variable protocol uses the continuous properties of photons, like coherent state, to encode information. On the other hand, the distributed phase reference encodes information on the difference of phase or time of the arrival of the photons on the receiving end. The first quantum key distribution protocol was proposed in 1984, and after that, many other protocols have also been proposed. We saw that many attacks can be lost against the quantum key distribution protocol. Different types of attack have been demonstrated against the quantum key distribution protocols, like side channel attacks, photon number splitting attack, Trojan horse attack, laser sifting attack, decoy method, and beam splitting. In order to overcome the limitation and attacks of the quantum key distribution protocol, a new approach was proposed in 2000. This technique is called quantum secure direct communication, in which sender and receiver do not need to exchange any type of key before carrying out the communication. Another technique to overcome the limitation of quantum key distribution protocol was deterministic secure direct communication. This technique permits the receiver to access the message only after one extra transmission of a classical type for each qubit, which is another significant use of quantum cryptography. To summarize, quantum cryptography is still in its early and developing stage, but it is a very important technique which will help us decode information in a post-quantum era. So I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the comment section. Until then, see you in the next video.